Hi everybody, my name is Chris and today we're going to be talking about registering for classes. This crash course is brought to you by the Start Advising Office Peer Advisors and we hope that you gain some useful knowledge from this presentation. So we begin with a quick reminder. Before START students are able to register for classes, they must speak with their academic advisor. To schedule an appointment, you can contact the START Advising Office by email at umd-start@umich.edu or by calling us at 313-593-5576. Now let's begin. When should you register? Registration is based on the amount of credits that students have completed here at the university, including anything that has been transferred. Based on these credits, the university has created a registration timetable, which can be found on our school website in addition to this helpful form on registration instructions. For more information on these resources, please visit the school website at www.umdearborn.edu and search for your desired information. These are helpful web pages that can clear up any confusion one might have regarding registration. Now we're going to talk about using Schedule Planner. Schedule Planner will generate potential class schedules to fit your needs. It simplifies the registration process and helps you find classes that fit around your busy schedule. You can select the courses you need to take and block off break times, work schedules, extracurricular activities, family obligations, etc. So now we're going to try it out together. So, to find Schedule Planner, you'll log into U of M Dearborn Connect, go to Student Services, after you click Enter Secure Area, Student Services, and then you'll go to Schedule Planner, which you will find below the Registration tab. Your information will show up here. You will then go to Term, click Change, select the term for which you want to register. Here you will be able to add or remove courses that you plan on taking for next semester, add or remove breaks that you plan on taking for next semester, generate schedules using those classes, and change your preferences. For example, instructional methods. If you have a preferred method of instruction, you can change that here so that only classes with that preferred instructional method will show up for you. The most important thing to remember when using Schedule Planner is that these are your classes. Play around with it a little bit and make sure your class schedule is unique to your desire so that you can have the experience that you want this upcoming semester. One final thing to remember is that courses in your registration cart do not mean that you are actually registered for those courses. You must log into U of M Dearborn Connect and click Submit before you register, and that will register you for those courses. Simply having them in your cart does not mean that you are registered for them. Other information that students must be aware of are the concepts of waitlisting, classes with labs, and cross-listed courses. Students cannot waitlist a section of a course when already registered for a section of the same course. Available seats will be given to those on the waitlist. Classes such as Biology 130 and Physics 125 have lab sections associated with them. These classes are pre-selected, so make sure to pick the best lecture and lab pair that fits your schedule. Some classes may look like there are spaces available even if they are in fact full. Check to make sure the class isn't listed under another name, as many of our courses are cross-listed to fit multiple requirements. As we continue next semester, in a hybrid format, information about asynchronous learning versus synchronous learning is essential. Asynchronous learning allows students to take online courses at their own pace. Instructors provide materials, lectures, tests, and assignments that can be accessed at any time. Students may be given a time frame, typically a one-week window, to complete assigned tasks. Synchronous classes require students and instructors to be online at the same time. Lectures, discussions, and presentations occur at a specific hour. All students must be online at that specific hour in order to participate and receive attendance for class. Next, we move on to some common registration errors. If you attempt to register and you are blocked by a class restriction, this may be a restriction related to the particular class attribute in which you are attempting to register. The same goes for college and major restrictions. If your particular college or degree program has restrictions in place that prevents you from registering for a specific course, you will be blocked by the error. Other errors include time conflicts in which one or more of your courses or class schedules conflict with each other, in a way that makes it impossible to take both courses at the same time. In other cases, you may have missed taking a prerequisite course or do not have the necessary placement exam test score that would exempt you from that prerequisite course, in which case you will need to take a prereq course for the course before registering for that which you are seeing the error with. Co-requisite courses are courses that need to be taken simultaneously with each other, as the information taught in one course is conjoined with the information talked about in another. If you're still having questions regarding registration, please feel free to meet with one of our peer advisors using the contact information on your screen. You can also view our office hours on our peer advising webpage. On behalf of the other peer advisors and myself, thank you for taking the time to watch our presentation, and we hope you found this information beneficial.